टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव डिस्कशन एंड द लेक्चर ऑन द फर्दर रिसर्च डायरेक्शन इन द केस ऑफ द सस्टेनेबल सप्लाई चेन मैनेजमेंट. व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट लिटरेचर रिव्यूज आर देयर, ए फ्रेमवर्क फॉर द लिटरेचर रिव्यू is given in this paper. And abstract of the paper is as follow. This paper argues for the use of the total interpretive structural modeling. In this paper, total interpretive structure modeling is done in the case of the sustainable supply chain management. TISM, total interpretive structural modeling. The literature has identified antecedent and drivers for the adoption of the sustainable supply chain management. What are the antecedents are there? What are the drivers of the, in the case of the sustainable supply chain management? It discusses briefly in the case of the, what are the drivers of the sustainable supply chain management. However, there is relatively little research on the methodological approaches and the techniques that take into account the dynamic nature of the sustainable supply chain management. There is the very little research on the methodical approaches and the techniques that take into the account the dynamic nature of the sustainable supply chain management. And bridge the existing quantitative qualitative divide. To address this gap, this paper firstly systematically reviews the literature on the sustainable supply chain management drivers. What are the different papers on the sustainable supply chain management drivers? Firstly, it reviews these papers. Secondly, it argues for the use of the alternative methods. What are the alternative methods are there? The third methods are there in the case of the sustainable supply chain management. To address the question related to the sustainable supply chain management driver. And thirdly, it proposes and illustrates the use of the total interpretive structure modeling and cross impact matrix multiplication applied to the classification. This is the MCMAC analysis. MCMAC analysis, cross impact matrix manipulation applied to the classification analysis to test a framework that extrapolates sustainable supply chain management drivers and their relationship. The framework depicts how drivers are distributed in the various levels and the how a particular driver influences the other through the transitive links. This paper concludes with the limitations and the further research directions. The keywords of this paper is the sustainable supply chain, total interpretive structure modeling, Micmac and the drivers. What are the drivers of the sustainable supply chain management is there? Introduction: in the recent times, sustainable supply chain management have become a topic of interest for the academics and the practitioners. Carter and the Roger, 2008. Salur and Miller, 2008. Fagul and the Wu, 2009. Carter and the Eston, 2011. A and the Sakraji, 2013. Pagel and the Sevaco, 2014. And Marcel et al., 2015. Lee et al., 2015. According to the Walmart, over 90% of its total emission related to its operation are from its supply chain. This is the Bichel 2010. The interesting fact is that more than 20% of the global greenhouse gases emissions are made by about 2,500 largest global company, and their supply chains are responsible for a major proportion of the emissions resulting from the corporate operation, Carbon Disclosure Project 2011. Because of globalization, distribution channels of the goods and services have become very complex. Router et al. 2010. And subsequently, the socio-economic condition of the respective regions are a major success factor of the supply chain network. Basque et al. 2008. This has led to the competition between the corporates based on the sustainability-oriented innovations. Nudmo et al. 2009, Hansen et al. 2009. Literature has also looked into the importance of the safety, diversity, equity, and other social and economic issues within the supply chain. Maloney and Brown, 2006, China and Tate, 2015. Now there is a rich body of literature on drivers of the sustainable supply chain management. A.G. Walker and Jones, 2012, Ahe and Sakraji, 2013, Dibet et al., 2014. The majority of the scholars have been engaging with the empirical methods, either quantitative or the qualitative, to create theoretical framework that entail drivers, Binder and Edward 2010 and the Sultani et al. 2014. In recent years, some scholars have argued that in its majority literature on the sustainable supply chain management has been following a dichotomistic view. On creating framework for the sustainable supply chain management drivers, following other deductive empirical research, Markham and Kursin 2014, or case study approaches, Merdit 1999, Pagel and Wu 2009, Katkowi and Cho 2014, Wallace 1993, argues that the over-reliance on the quantitative methods hamper the theoretical framework development process. Since the qualitative methods may do in-depth analysis of the problem through and the inductive process, while the theory generated by the using qualitative methods remain untested, Hardy 2000. Deductive approaches are highly reliable but may fail to give the new insights, Markman and Kurso 2014. Cases that build theory are often regarded as the most interesting researches. Bartuk et al. 2006. There are a considerable amount of the case study researches in the sustainable supply chain management area, but there is no clarity or the criteria mentioned for the selection of the case. Data collection methodology or the number of cases under study. Grimpro et al. 2006. Hence, in many situations, case studies may not become an effective tool for the developing a strategic framework for a philosophical idea. The use of the case study for theory building has been criticized on the grounds of the ambiguity of the inferred hypothesis and the selective bias. Bytecan 2008 and the Barat ETL 2011, especially by those scholars who are not familiar with the qualitative methods. Vickerton 2008 wrote 2007. This paper aims to bridge this debate by arguing for the use of the total interpretive structure modeling. We are driven by the endorsement of a scholar such as a Bharat ETL 2011 and the Taylor and the Taylor 2009 to utilize alternative research methods and the framework to explain operation management and the supply chain management related phenomena, and to build robust approaches and the techniques that consider the dynamic environment of the supply chain management. And in our case, sustainable supply chain management, instead of employing either deductive or the inductive approaches, we draw on system theory and use of the total interpretive structural modeling to develop and test a framework that explores sustainable supply chain management driver and their relationship. Based on a systematic literature review on the sustainable supply chain management driver, Sushil 2012 argue that the system theory and the system engineering based methods may provide a helping hand to the organizational research on this front. Identification of the structure within a system is of the great value in the dealing effectively with the system and better decision. Structural models may include interaction matrices and the graph, delta chart, signal flow graph, etc., which lack an interpretation of the embedded object or the represented system. However, the total interpretive structure modeling based approach offers flexibility to enhance interpretive logic of the systems engineering tools, not only in delineating a hierarchical structure of the intended organizational theory, but also to interpret the links in order to explain the causality of the conceptual model by using the strength of the paired comprehension methodology. According to the Nassim 2011 and the Sushil 2012, interpretive structure modeling fails to explain the causal relationship for the transitive links between the construct of the model. Interpretive structure modeling is considered to be an extension of the interpretive structure modeling, which helps to overcome these limitations. But even though there is a growing attention on the total interpretive structure modeling methodology, there are a limited study that used TISM as a methodology to develop a theoretical framework. Goyer and Grover 2012, Mangata et al. 2014, Prasad and Suri 2011, Singh and Sushil 2013, Srivastava and Sushil 2014, Yadav and Sushil 2014, and the Dubey et al. 2015, who suggest it's used for theory building in the sustainable manufacturing. Therefore, in this paper, we undertake an extensive literature review and identify key drivers of the sustainable supply chain management practices. And number two, use the total interpretive structure and the MIC-MAC analysis to understand the relationship among the drivers of the sustainable supply chain management practices and develop a theoretical sustainable supply chain management driver framework. The rest of the paper is organized as follows. In the following section, we outline our systematic literature review. In the third section, we outline our research theoretical framework. And research methodology. In section four, we present our sustainable supply chain management theoretical framework as the outcome of the MIC-MAC analysis. We relate this to the literature in discussion. Section 5, in this section, we conclude our research and provide further research direction. Literature review. Sustainable supply chain and the drivers. Sustainable supply chain concerns the management of the material, information, and capital flow, as well as cooperation among the company along the supply chain. while taking goals from all three dimensions of the sustainable development, economic, environmental, and social, into account, which are derived from the customer and the stakeholder requirement. Securing and Muller 2008. Review of the literature on the definition of the sustainable supply chain management. Carter and the Eastern, Ahi and Sakrasi, Pagel and the Sivisco 2014. Says that the sustainable supply chain management is the voluntary integration of the social, economic, and the environmental consideration with the key into the organizational business system to create a coordinated supply chain to effectively manage the material, information, and the capital flow associated with the procurement, production, and distribution of the products or services to fulfill short-term and the long-term profitability. A stakeholder requirement, competitiveness, and resilience of the organization. Therefore, the sustainable supply chain management can be understood as a supply chain management focusing on the maintaining environmental, economic, and the social stability for the long-term sustainable growth. Linton, ETL 2007, Ahi and the Sakrasi 2013, Lepet ETL 2013. A literature review was conducted for the purpose of this research following the tenets of the systematic literature review. Explained by the Tranfield et al. 2003 and the later study, Rowley and Stack, Burgage et al. 2006, Cousin et al., Chen et al., and the Gunasekaran et al. 2015. The literature review aimed to identify and classify drivers of the sustainable supply chain management. The papers were derived using the keywords from the following database. These are the databases which have been described here. ProQuest, ScienceDirect, IFSCO, Scopus, Imral, Springer, Inspec, and the CompoundX. The keywords we include were sustainable supply chain, green supply chain, sustainability, drivers, and the strategic framework. Within these databases, we assess reputable journals in the field of the operation and the sustainable supply chain management, as well as edited books and the reports. These papers were further scanned and analyzed to identify and interpret themes and features. This process yielded 10 articles that have been included in our research. From this literature, we classified the key drivers of the sustainable supply chain management. 12 themes arose as described in the following subsection. Green warehousing. Warehouses generated much of the packaging waste in the supply chain. The use of the standard reusable containers is a solution for this to reduce cost and eliminate waste. Maximizing storage area utilization, minimizing storage and the retrieval cost, and the minimizing energy usage are the important objectives that are to be taken care of at the warehouses. Wu and Domon, 1995, Harris et al. 2011, emphasized the importance of a proper warehouse management system for the sustainability performance. Wang et al. 2015 underlined the importance of the recycling facility at the warehouses. Other scholars, Rizzo 2006, Colcheria et al. 2011, and the McMahon et al. 2010 have recognized the importance of the warehouse sustainability and suggest that the green warehouses and the issue related to the use of the green energy sources and the strategy as well as the adoption of the energy efficient handling technology are important topics for the future sustainability research. Therefore, we identify green housing as one of the main sustainable supply chain management driver. Another issue is the strategic supplier collaboration. Collaboration helps to commercialize and to ensure easy access to the innovative technology for the local and the lower tier suppliers in the supply chain. Bochan and the Klassen 2008 Damon and the Petka 2014 and the Glover ETL 2014. Research on the role of the environmental collaboration has mainly focused on its antecedent and the performance implementation. Zhu ETL 2013 and the Greekawa ETL 2016 and the Lee 2000 illustrates the success story of the inter-organizational supply chain collaboration, which helped Hewlett Packard, Electrolux, Sony and the Baron companies to reduce the recycling and the disposal cost by the 35% by developing a common European recycling platform. Collaborative planning, forecasting and the replacement system help organization to easily overcome financial barriers as well, which lead to the successful achievement of the sustainability initiative in the supply chain. Attard and Attan 2007, in a later study, Chow ETL 2011 discussed the impact of the environmental collaboration on the internal processes. Environmental sustainability, referring to the benefits such as a clean technology, lower energy consumption, and the material reuse. Greekawa ETL 2006 suggests that the environmental supplier collaboration can enhance the focal firm's performance both directly. Zhu ETL 2007, De Guanami 2012, and indirectly Dyer and Singh 1990. That is, by stimulating the firm to invest in and implement more sustainable process that influence the firm's performance. Thus, we argue that the strategic supplier collaboration is acute for the success of the sustainable supply chain management and is considered as one of the drivers of the sustainable supply chain management. Environment conservation. Researchers are enormously in favor of the arguments to conserve the environment for the sustainable development. The Intergovernmental Panel on the Climate Change demands the full stoppage of the fossil fuel usage by the 2100 to control the world carbon footprint. Many of the articles in the literature explain the need for the eco-friendly processes. Technology, product, energy efficient system, and the conservation technique. YJ ETL 2012, Abbasi and Nielsen 2012, Godsey ETL 2014, and according to Wu and Pagel 2011, environmental strategy adopted by the organization have a direct impact on the supply chain and competitiveness of the organization. GETL explains various methods for the environmental conservation, which include improving demand forecast accuracy, investment in the carbon reduction technology, joint distribution, adopting cross-docking network, improving energy efficiency, combining design for the ecology, and the comprehensive take-back network. Thus, we argue to consider environment conservation as an important driver of the sustainable supply chain framework. Next issue is the continuous improvement. Audit, assessment, and the standardization are considered to be the key tools for the continuous improvement, which help organizations to quantify the performance and to continuously strive for the better sustainability performance. Batman 2005, Sevno and Maja 2014, Matt Rizzo and the Juada and the Miano and Fujit 2014. Organization can either adopt standard assessment practices such as ISO 14000, eco-management, and the European Union audit scheme. Chen 2005, Calendar ETL 2015, and the Corvac 2011, or can go for their one assessment system to the continuously improve their performance. Spence and the Volkish 2009, Forestell ETL 2010. Audit and standardization help organizations to benchmark their practices with best in class prevailing in the world and can try to achieve the same. Turker and Atmel 2014, Grosswood ETL 2014, Chain and Maria 2014. Hence, we argue that the continuous improvement initiate play an important role in the successful implementation of the sustainable supply chain management. enabling information technology. Nowadays, sustainable and eco-friendly technology are the fast approaching parity in terms of the conventional solution. Gunasekaran and Negi 2004, Kuranch and Tarabdar 2014. Sustainable technology are the reconfigurable, recyclable, and the cleaner technology that don't harm society and the nature. Liu et al. 2011, Korean et al. 1919, and Liu and Luang 2008. According to Sarkis and Vermish, waste treatment is the another important area that needs attention in the sustainable development strategy. Thus, we argue that the enabling technology and the information must be considered as an enabler in the strategic framework formulation of the sustainable supply chain. Logistic optimization can be explained as the optimization of the speed, route, load, and the nature of the transport. Optimization of the speed, optimization of the route, optimization of the load, and or nature of the transport. Use of the alternate fuels instead of the fossil fuels. Reverse logistics, logistic collaboration, which will significantly contribute to the profitability margin and the greenhouse gas emission control of the business organization. NITO ETL 2008, Gerty and Tesh 2011, Boxy ETL 2015. Helderson and Knox also emphasize the need to have the energy efficient logistics and the supply chain system for the better sustainability and the reduced global carbon footprint. Dolasti and the Golgip Toro ETL 2004 further emphasize the need to develop reverse logistic network to increase the utilization of the resources and for the reuse and recycling of the product. In a recent study, Nicolo ETL 2013, integrate corporate social responsibility and sustainability issue in the reverse logistic system and relate them to the sustainability performance based on the triple bottom line approach. By and the Sarkis suggests that more research should be done into the corporation of the logistic optimization for understanding sustainable green supply chain research and the practice. Hence, we argue to consider logistic optimization as one of the relevant drivers of the sustainable supply chain management, in which the main the optimization issue are the speed, route, load, and nature of the transport, use of the alternate fuel instead of the fossil fuel. Reverse logistics, logistic collaboration. This is the logistic optimization. Internal pressure can be explained as the pressure and the demands from the employee of an organization. Scholars, Hanna et al. 2000, Carter and Roger 2008 have highlighted the role of the employee involvement and the loyalty for the success of the sustainable initiative. To maintain high employee morale and the loyalty, labor sustainability is to be considered by ensuring the proper working condition and the health and the well-being of the employee. Taprio and the Kogan 2008, Lapsu and the Baron 2008, Monte and the Liret 2009 further argue for the socially responsible purchasing for the better sustainability performance. However, scholars have also suggested that despite the pressure, change management experts still don't possess the knowledge of how achieve sustainability. Jabloor and the Jabloor 2009. Scholars also suggest that the employee engagement in the sustainability is a significant challenge since sustainability requires changes to the practice and the routines. Carter et al. 2007, Gettiger and Carter 2010. Hence, internal resistance needs to be studied more extensively. Carter et al. 2007. Bagel and the Govely 2009, Gettiger and Carter 2010, and hence internal pressure is an important driver of the sustainable supply chain management. Institutional pressures, according to the DiMago and the Powell, organizational process are institutionalized following an adaptive process that is influenced by the individual, leading to the institutional isomorphism. This term is used to denote the consequence of the imitation or the governmental regulatory norms. Institutional theory can help us understand hence the adoption of the practices and the intention behind their adoption or the implementation. The three dimension of the institutional theory are the coercive pressure, normative pressure, and the minimic pressure. Dimago and the Powell, 1983. Coercive isomorphism is the outcome of the formal and the informal external pressure. Bias, agency, regulatory norms, normative isomorphism is the result of the proportional. That is the collective struggle of the members of an occupation to define the working condition and their methods to work, and in future guide the future proportional through legitimacy. Mimetic isomorphism is the outcome of the mimic other organizational action, especially when there is limited clarity of the organizational goal or when there is uncertainty with regards to the environment in which an organization operates or when the organization does not have an in-depth understanding of the technology. Dimago and the Powell, 1983. Leon et al., 2007. In operation management and the supply chain management research, institutional theory has been used to explain the adoption. Katku and the Sauder, 2004. Kachan and the Hult, 2007. Liu et al., 2010. And Sarkis et al., 2011. Baku and the Chow, 2013. Copy, 2013. Zhao et al., 2007. Have uninvestigated the impact of the coercive and the normative pressure on the adoption of the sustainable supply chain management. Where Baku and the Chow discuss the institutional pressure emerging while an organization initiative to adopt inter-organizational system present a case study to show the importance of the legislation in purchasing organization to adopt environmentally friendly practices. Since the impact of the institutional pressure on the sustainable supply chain management is yet to be realized. Kuchen and Holt, 2007. Kai et al., 2010, and the Law and Gunasekaran, 2012, copy 2013, we argued that the institutional pressure is a very important driving force of the sustainable supply chain management. Social value and the ethics. What are the role of the social value are there? What are the role of the ethics are there in the case of the sustainable development has received immense attention in the recent year and become a major topic of the debate among the researchers. Strong business ethics is an essential factor for the success of the sustainability initiative in an organization. Gunasekaran and Spenge, 2010. Derke and Skelter, 2008. Roberts, 2013. And the Mueller, 2009. And the Gloss et al., 2011. Suggests that the value and ethics contribute to the successful collaboration, ethical sourcing, and the purchasing. Behmann further argues that the engineering ethics play a major role in the design and development of an environmentally conclusion supply chain. In a recent study, suggests that the future research should aim to understand ethic and moral responsibility in the supply chain. Thus, we can see that the social value and ethics is the one of the drivers of the sustainable supply chain management. This is the very important part of the driver of the sustainable supply chain, social value and the ethics. Corporate strategy and the commitment. A clear strategic level policy and the coordination of the strategic level team with the tactical and operational levels of the organization is essential for the introduction and implementation of the sustainable development in an organization. Law and Gunasekaran, 2012. A lack of the corporate strategy and the lack of the management involvement will hamper organization sustainability achievement efforts. Griep and Patrick, 2001. Carter and the Dejan, 2001. Nursingham and Das, 2001. And the Day and the Listen, 2006. Further argue that the alignment of the sustainable supply chain management strategy and the corporate strategy is also very important. Additional literature highlighted the role of the commitment, especially from the top management, as a priority for the supply chain partners who seek to implement sustainability practices. Liang et al., 2007, Gettiker and Carter, 2010, Forrester et al., 2015, in recent Abraham et al., 2014, and Javar and the D'Souza Javar, 2016, and the relationship between the commitment and the sustainable practices has been illustrated. Thus, we must consider corporate strategy and the commitment as an important driver of the sustainable supply chain management. Economic stability, one of the most driver of the sustainable supply chain is the economic stability. Have noted that the sustainable supply chain management practices help to shorten the supply chain pipeline, build an agile supply chain channel, lower cost in the supplier management. Supply chains can react to the market changes rapidly and less waste in inventory. During the economic meltdown, the fashion organization with the sustainable supply chains have performed better in comparison to those who have relied on their traditional supply chain. WTO RTL 2008. Hence, we argue that the economic stability is an important factor. By the WTO RTL, green product design. Gradial RTL 1995 have argued that the green product design is the one of the major focus area of the some of the most successful organization. For instance, AT&T has developed and applied a design for the environment evolution methodology to its telecommunication products. Chen argued that the green product development, which addresses environmental issue through the product design and innovation as opposed to the traditional end of the pipes and control approach, is receiving significant attention from the customer, industry and the government around the world. Have noted that some organizations have discovered green design positively impacts business performance. Some of the scholars in their works have also noted that the green product design has significant positive influence on the sustainable business development. Linton ETL 2007, Duncan Pujari 2010, and Sarma ETL 2010, Alvas ETL 2014, and the Zhu ETL 2010. Hence, we argue that the green product design is one of the important drivers of the sustainable supply chain management. The need for the alternative technology in the sustainable supply chain management for the theory building, TISM. Our literature review reveals that the majority of the study within the sustainable supply chain management don't build the theory, but rather am testing particular hypothesis stemming from the literature, mainly through the use of the quantitative methods. Have argued that the simply reporting factors, loading or the beta coefficient, rarely establishes causality. There are the case study, but these aim at explaining how and why particular phenomena takes place without aiming at the building theory from the data. These frameworks do not provide a clear understanding of the links between the hierarchical relationship between the construct. Furthermore, there are the few studies that use the interpretive structure modeling to build theoretical framework. Thakkar et al. 2008, Ali and Govindan 2010, Matthew et al. 2018, and the Luthra 2005. Hence, we consider view on what constitutes a good operation management theory. These works do not adhere to correctly suggested what is the uniqueness, pessimism, conservation, generality, functionality, empirical riskiness, and the abstraction. They either test theory or attempt to support past literature. Total emphatic structure modeling to build theory through the strategic theoretical framework development is an extension of the ISM. TISM aims to deal with the limitation of the ISM regarding the limited explanation it offers on the transitive links, the causality of the linkage, building blocks of the ISM model. TISM model has been used by the researcher Goyal and Grover 2012, Mangla et al. 2014, Prasad and Suri 2011, Singh and Susil 2013, Srivastava and Susil 2014, Yadav and Susil 2014. However, apart from the study, that the focused building framework to explore how human agency theory and institutional theory can contribute to the sustainable manufacturing and particular ecological modernization theory. So far, we have been used to generate the theory. In terms of the statistical theoretical framework in the supply chain management, giving the use the inputs for this research. the steps of the TSM are discussed in the next stage.